Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're on the start of another walk. This one, we're in the town of Egham. Egham is quite near Staines, which is in Surrey, along the Thames, Staines upon Thames. Egham is the next town along to it, and also quite close to Laleham Green, which I've done in a previous video. Now we're going to have a little walk around the town. See what we can find shop-wise. Currently a Sunday, sort of late February, quite cold still, the tail end of winter. Hopefully spring's going to be coming along pretty soon, but it's around about 6 or 7 degrees. It's a Sunday afternoon, so I'm not sure how busy it'll be here in Egham, but going by the traffic, it looks fairly busy. Going to walk up the hill, see what we can see. Now, I have been to Egham before, a few times. Not on a walking tour though, generally driving through. In fact, I've actually cycled through it a couple of times as well. So, not quite sure what's here, but it'll be your average shops and restaurants, I should say, think. We've got the little Crown pub over there. The Sunday roasts, looks quite busy. We'll cross over and walk down through here. So you've got a lot of new development going on here. Stations over there on the right. Might have a look down that way. But for now we'll walk straight on into the high street. The old bank, 1796 established, built, rebuilt 1896, over 100 years ago. Doesn't look like it's a bank anymore. Good job I stopped there, you could walk right past that. We've got Egham Museum, the Literary Institute. Not sure what goes on in there. Well, there's no shortage of pubs in Egham. Red Lion. Red Lion at Egham. Pretty busy watching the football. Church of Egham. Go across the other side to get a look at that. Yep, I like that. Sunday. Some wonderful old brickwork as well. Very decorative. just looking at the cost of it, would have been an older butcher's. Just look at the sign there, established 1877, R. Clark, butcher and grazier. If we can zoom in on that. It's a great way to keep the old buildings, I have to say. Another shop with some traditional old frontage on it, with the old tiles. Iranian all-day dining. That's quite busy as well. Egg and Montos, 2 G's. Some nice little shops. Exhaust coming out of that car just went past. Oh. That was grim. Right, that's the end of the high street. You've got the M25, Staines and Windsor. Going that way, but we're not going to go that way. We're going to go back. But we might cross over actually. In fact, I think we will. That is quite windy. Hopefully it's not going to affect the audio too much. Oh, we're across. Egham Fire Station, Egham Community Fire Station. I see it's been well gritted. Obviously you don't want a fireman come running out slipping over on the way to rescue a cat up a tree. That wouldn't be good. Egham District Social Club. Now that is an old build. Excuse me. That is an old building there. It's got the original lettering on it and all, by the look of it. Not sure if there's any socialising going on anymore. Looks like it's boarded up. Another example of tuck pointing on the brickwork. You can see there, the red muck in between the bricks and the line put through it. So we've got the old bell there as well. Let people in. No, looks like it's closed, boarded up. Or maybe the entrance is round the back. Have a look. There's a local church. Looks pretty closed up. Maybe it is open, I don't know. Gates are locked. Anyway, we'll have a quick look over here. Really ancient tombstones there. Maybe they're built underneath the actual church. I think that's written in Latin, which I wouldn't know what it meant. But that says Magna Carta Caput One. Caput, doesn't that mean finish? don't know if we can get out there. Possibly can, but I'm going to walk back anyway. Oh, the squirrels are out. Still February, they'll come out a little bit early. Here's the entrance to the churchyard. I thought it was a bus show when I walked past it, but there's the original timbers, the original gate hinge. John Wesley passed this way and preached in 1744. To the memory of Robert Henry Trier, first fireman of the borough of Runnymede and a true friend of Egham, 1912 to 1984. There's another plaque up there, but I can't quite read what it says on that one. Okay. That goes around the back of Egham. We'll have a quick look around there. Don't think there's much to see. Gambrel stones in the junior water. I don't think there's a shopping mall in Egham. Maybe there is. Waitrose there, but there's that gate we looked at, so we could have come out of there, but I wouldn't have seen that arch. Never walk past an arch when you can walk under it, that's what I say. Here really, just the back of Waitrose car park. just residential here. Over. So it's a mixture of shops, residential and commercial buildings, pretty much like any average town really. We always have the commercial side of it behind the shopping precinct. This is the entrance to Waitrose, we'll have a look down here. Don't think there's a shopping centre as such, there's a travel lodge though. Well, 15 to 2015, that was the Magna Carta. Yep, celebrating 800 years. Freedom and peace. Okay, so it's quite a modern shopping centre really. But it's got a lot of the old original buildings which are kept intact, which I always like to see. Which seems to give it some sort of authenticity to the area. The old mixed with the new can't be a bad thing. Oh, someone's had a few too many. It's only the middle of the afternoon as well. I do like that old bank there, it's worth another look. It's a pity it's no one's taking over that and turning it into a shop. But obviously it'd be protected, they wouldn't be able to knock it down. I wouldn't have thought. Station Road North, does that take you up to the station? Should we have a look? That's some interesting brickwork. Not seen that before. Tiled brickwork and original old stocks. Berto Lounge. Mixture of the old and the new. Station Road North. All modern towns have a piazza now. It seems. And a gym. Yep, good view, I like that. They've mixed the old with the new and done a good job of it. Always good to see. Well, I haven't found, managed to find a station or a sign pointing to the station. It's probably around here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Station to the right. I should have known people walking down there, really. We'll have a quick look. We can't come all this way. Not very well signed. If you're on foot. I like that, that's very well designed. That's quite an old house. Nope, still can't find a station. I suppose I could put it on Google Maps really, but it's pointing back up here now. I'm not walking back up. I have to do that another day. Well, that's probably it anyway for this one. It was quite a good, interesting walk around the old town and looking at some of the residential properties. We didn't make the station, but it's not very well signed. They've got two signs here for bikes, but it's not really great if you're on foot. But anyway, thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.